In Development League 2 South, the under-21s made it 4 wins in a row on Monday night as they saw off Colchester at Landor. Modu Barrow returned to the side after making his Premier League debut and was immediately involved as his trickery inside the box created an opening for James Loveridge, who hit a fine shot beyond the goalkeeper. That was also Loveridge's second goal in as many games after returning from his loan spell at Newport County. In a game of few chances, the hosts survived a scare with just over 20 minutes to play as Colchester striker Macaulay Bonn went through on goal, and after his initial effort was superbly kept out by Oliver Davis, the striker's follow-up shot was headed away by Alex Gogic. The visitors continued to press and came close again as Michael O'Donoghue's surging run caused havoc in the Swans' defence, and midfielder Byron Lawrence saw his curling shot flick the top of the crossbar. But the home side scored an all-important second goal with just 5 minutes left to play as Ryan Hedges set up Henry Jones and the substitute weaved his way into the box before sliding the ball beyond the goalkeeper.
Well, obviously we are not happy at the moment because we've lost again at that particular ground, and the way we played was not what we used to do over the whole season so far. We had a couple of good moments, yes, but in general we've been outworked, and that is actually a key thing this season for us, that we haven't been outworked in any of our former games, so that was quite disappointing. Yeah, as for, I think at the start of the season he was a bit, he needed a bit, a few games to come back into it because he wasn't regularly playing at Tottenham. But once he was, he's basically the one as he was when he left us. So he's magnificent with the standards, the set pieces, and I think he evolved a lot, and and everything comes together now. He's fitting in perfectly with Boney and the other midfield player, so he's a very important player for us. To be fair, yeah, I did. Of course, you could see what he is doing on the training. From last season, from the end of last season, you could see what his idea is of how he wants to play, and he's bringing it now into the new season, and the players are fully committed and fully behind him, and that's a huge advantage, I'd say, because he's not struggling with any problems inside the team, so that helps a lot. And yeah, so the whole team is backing him and following his ideas, and it works out. Yeah, as always, I'm always happy when I'm playing. I was hoping for a bit longer run in the Capital One Cup. Didn't turn off this year. We had some tough opponents though. Away to Liverpool is always a tough task, and this year we couldn't do it. But of course, playing in the league is a different story, and always looking forward to it.
Tom, firstly, tell us what this project today is all about.
It's part of the Premier League for Sport project. Basically, the project is all about getting more young people involved in sport, using the brand of Swansea City in the Premier League as a pull. So we've got three target sports, which are tennis, table tennis and hockey. So we're running various sessions throughout Swansea, Carmarthen, Neath, offering sort of taster sessions, fun sessions. They're all free. So the chance for the young people to come along, give it a go, see if they like it. And if they do like it, they can take it further then.
Well, lads, you've come along to this project this evening. Tell us what you thought of it so far.
Obviously, yeah, I'm surprised at the standard, to be honest. Two little kids over there are very, very good. But obviously, I'm a lot better than him, obviously, but...
Why did you get involved in this project?
I thought it'd be fun to try out something because I don't have anything doing on a Monday, so, and I wanted to try out, see if I'd get into a Swans team. So.
Scott, you had a chance to play Di earlier. But I know there's always a bit of a rivalry whenever teammates play each other at any sport. Who won?
Be honest.
He beat me 12-10, but I think a little interference and a crowd watching, I think I'll beat him if I play him again.
Would you say it's improved your table tennis skills in that
time? Yeah, a lot. Keep practicing and stuff like that, like it helps me.
It's been fantastic, really. The kids have really embraced the project. I think it's offering them, it's the added sort of ingredient, if you like, to push them towards trying these new sports. Obviously, many people haven't tried table tennis before. Tennis can be a bit quiet in the winter, but having the Swansea logo and brand behind it really does help push the kids into getting more involved.
I think it brings the boys together, I think, as well, especially you can see all these lot, they play, communicate with each other, obviously, and I think it's a good thing to have.
Obviously, they do get the chance to represent the Swans. That's a big, big part of it, pulling on the Swans shirt, playing against the other Premier League teams, Man United, Chelsea, Arsenal, at table tennis. So there's going to be opportunities later in the year for some lucky participants to go on and do that.
The kids appreciate it. You coming along just to talk to them, just to see them. They appreciate it so much, and the kids here, their faces lit up when we walked in today, so it's really nice for everyone, really.
Who are we?